Hey, what's up guys? Theo Joe here, and recently I got the Pixel phone by Google, and it runs Android 7.1. So I thought you guys would be interested in 10 of the coolest new features in Android 7.1 Nougat, whether you have a Pixel phone or if you're gonna update your phone to it in the future. Oh, and by the way, these aren't really gonna be in any particular order. Starting off, the first one is app shortcuts with a long press. This is a pretty popular one. Most of you guys already know about this, but basically now on many apps, you can long press on that icon and it will bring up some shortcuts that you can instantly jump to and do an action in that app. So you don't have to click on the app, navigate to whatever button, very similar to Apple's Force Touch on their iPhone. So one specific example is in Google Chrome, you can long press it and it gives you the option to bring up a regular or incognito tab right away. These shortcuts do need to be added by the developer, so there's not really that many apps yet that support it. It's mostly just Google made apps, obviously, but it's still super convenient. I'm sure we're gonna start to see these very soon. Next, number two is nightlight mode, which is a very similar feature to the iPhone's night shift, as well as the program Flux if you have that on desktop. So what this basically does is removes blue light from the screen, specifically at night, and shifts it more towards orange, because we know several studies have showed that blue light, bright screens, tend to keep you up at night. So this will remove that light that interferes with your ability to fall asleep. And I'm really glad they added this feature, because before on older versions, you had to use these third-party apps that didn't really work. They just kind of overlaid this ugly red filter. It looked terrible. I'm just glad they have it as a native feature now. Next, number three is the system UI tuner, which is actually kind of a hidden feature. What you do to enable this is pull down the notifications menu, and then you hold down the cog wheel, and a wrench will appear to show that it's enabled. And now in the settings, you have a system UI tuner menu. And this will give you some extra options that aren't usually available. So for example, enabling the battery percentage to show up in the status bar and adding some extra toggles in the status bar that you can change. And it also gives you power notification tools, which is really useful. It lets you have way more control over what notifications each app can do or can't do. So for example, if one app is being really annoying, you can set it so it can't wake up the screen or can't interrupt anything or can't even show notifications at all. It gives you a lot of fine detail control. Number four is an awesome new feature for when Android has to update. Before, you guys might have known every time you updated the phone, when you rebooted it, you had to wait for every app to compile. And if you had a lot of apps, it took forever and you just couldn't even use your phone. Now with the just-in-time feature, it does that all in the background so you don't have to wait for that to happen during boot. So it boots instantly and the apps just compile when you can actually still use your phone. So now updates are just gonna be way more easier, save you a ton of time, no more waiting after you update. Number five is emergency information and the ability to add medical information that is relevant in an emergency that is accessible from the lock screen. You can add information like blood type, your name, your medications you're on, etc. So if you pass out or something, paramedics can look at your phone and get all that relevant information. The only issue I see is that it's kind of hidden away from the lock screen. You have to click emergency, then click emergency information a couple times, and then it shows you the information. So I don't think most people are gonna even know that this is there. So it might not help as much, but I guess if these medics are taught that that information is there, might still be useful. Next, number six are moves, which are basically like physical gestures you can do to activate certain things. For example, on the fingerprint sensor, you can swipe down your finger to bring down the status bar and show you notifications. There's also one where you can press the power button twice and anywhere you are will instantly jump to the camera, although I think that is in a lot of phones already. And if you're already in the camera app, you can twist your hand two times and it will switch between the selfie camera and the back camera without having to press any buttons. So these are just kind of neat. There's only a few right now, but they might add more in the future. Number seven is the Daydream VR platform. So Google recently implemented native virtual reality support, and they also announced a headset, a physical headset to use with this phone called the Daydream View. Unfortunately, I don't have one of these new headsets yet, so I can't show you it yet. I will be getting one, but it'll still be good to see developers creating cool new VR apps, and it'll be interesting to see what kind of stuff they come up with. Now, next, number eight is call blocking and spam protection. Basically, if you go to the phone app, then you go to the settings, there is an option to add specific numbers to a block list. So if you're getting a spam call a bunch of times a week, or one person you just want to completely ignore, you can add that number to the block list and you won't have to hear from them. Also, they added a spam blocking feature. It's on by default. You can see that in the settings. So this will just block spams and scams. So that's nice. Coming near the end, number 9 is a small new feature, but still appreciated. Now, if you go into the app switcher and scroll all the way to the top, it will now show a clear all option. So if you want to clear out all the recent apps, you don't have to swipe each one individually anymore on stock Android. Obviously, other phones and skins like Samsung have had this for a while, but now it's nice that they added it into the native Android. And finally, number 10 is hundreds of new emojis. I think we can all appreciate this. It complies now with Unicode 9, which added a bunch of them. And one of the notable things is now for most of the people emojis, you can have different skin colors. So it's supposed to be gender and race neutral, so you can basically pick whatever one you want. And what you do is when there's a person emoji, you can hold down on that and it will show you all sorts of different variations of that emoji. So if you want a white person or a black person or a woman or a man, you can now pick any of those by holding it down. And it also does that on the hand emojis, although I don't really know if there's any other emojis that have options besides the people ones, like the object ones. I think they're all just the same. And so that's it. Those are 10 of the coolest features I thought that were added to Android 7.1 and a couple of them even to 7.0. I would love to hear what you guys think. If I missed any big ones that you think I should have mentioned, let us know down in the comment section. We can talk about that down there. And if you like this video, definitely give it a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it. I'd appreciate it. If you want to subscribe, I make new videos like this every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, sometimes even more, so it should be worth it. Also, if you guys want to keep watching, I've got some other videos right here that you should enjoy. You can click on these even if you're on a phone. It's a new type of annotation, so I hope you enjoy those as well. So again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.